Hello there, Scorpios. Welcome to your tarot reading. So before I go into this reading, let me just preface this. I feel like this is strongly a love reading, okay? I'm gonna touch on a few things here about your finances and career and things like that. But generally, no news is good news in that matter, in that front. So let me just, you know, for those who might be concerned, let me just touch a little bit on that. And then let me just go through the image that I saw when I shuffle the cards out. And then we'll go from there, okay? Because I feel like, I hope you guys have had a really good month in January. Because I feel this is a continuation of that, okay? The energy is very buoyant, okay? I feel like it's definitely a continuation because I feel like there's a lot of light-hearted, airy type of energy coming through for the month of February. So I feel you're going to be quite happy. Okay, I don't see like heavy burdens and things like that. And so I feel that it is going to be relatively a good month as well. So let me touch on a few things. First of all, we have here the King of Pentacles, okay, King of Crystals. And this is pretty much being in a situation where financially you've made it, okay? You're able to take care of yourself. You have disposable income. You can like have enough money to do recreational things, taking a trip, going out, going to the movies, going out dining. You don't have to nickel and dime yourself. So this is a state of financial prosperity for many of you. And I feel like the work environment, it is very harmonious at this point. It's also very stable. So I feel that you're settling in, okay? Like you're able to, you don't have to worry, like when is the other shoe gonna drop? When am I gonna get laid off? When am I gonna, am I gonna be able to make the bills? Am I gonna be able to pay all the bills or pay all the expenses? I don't feel you are in dire strait in any way when it comes to your financial footing. But, you know, once again, this is a general reading and a lot of people are watching this, and we also have cross watchers who are watching this, and we have like people who might be, especially I'm feeling Scorpio moon people in particular. I feel that your finances and your financial standing and your professional life, it is very solid, it's very golden, and I feel that you're making quite a bit of money, okay? And the reason that I say that, in particular, Scorpio Moon, is we have here underneath it is the Six of Cups, which I generally associate astrologically. It is Moon in Scorpio. And so right on top of that, with this King of Pentacles, it's indicative of stability, okay? Having a lot of financial abundance, having a lot of financial stability where you don't have to save up for a rainy day. You can spend all you want, but you know, your bank account is not depleted, okay? So it's like making a lot more money than you're spending. A lot more is coming in than is going out. So this is a really, really good space to be. And for those of you whose finances or job prospects or even, you know, career projects and things like that, if things have been a little bit shaky, I feel like the end of the February timeframe, we're going to transition into a lot more financial stability. So I just want to put that out there because I do want to relay the image that I saw here that came through, okay? So I don't know if there are a lot of people who are gamers, okay? But I saw an image of a video game. And I cannot for the life of me remember the name of the video game. But it basically involves this boy. He's a warrior. He looks very young. And there's a girl. She's like in spirit form. So she's kind of see-through and translucent. And so throughout the game, he has to rescue her. Okay, so throughout the game, he has to rescue her, and he's a warrior, he's athletic, so he's able to climb over cliffs and jump and things like that. But when he's with her, he has to help her down the cliff because, you know, she's not strong, like, she's not as strong as he is, she's not used to it. I think she might have been a princess, too. But it's like a role-playing game, and it's an RPG game, and that's all I remember from it. But when I saw that image, I was thinking about that video game. And so he jumps down into the cliff, and then he has to kind of like catch her when she jumps, or he has to like kind of like lower her onto the ground. So there's a series of like maneuvers that he's doing, and then all along the way, he's helping her Okay, so when I first saw this, I was thinking about, one person being very able to do something and another person is not. So, but contrary to what we would associate with like a codependent relationship, I feel like this is a very caring, nurturing type of a connection where somebody is very considerate of the other person's needs, okay? And I feel like there might have been parts in the game. I believe that she's showing him where to go. So they kind of like it's a symbiotic relationship. One person is lacking in something and the other person makes up for it. Okay, so it's like when one person's not able to do something, the other partner steps up. So I feel like there is a lot of mutual trust, a lot of like, I trust you enough to let you lead the way. Okay, I trust you enough to put my life in your hands. I trust you enough that if I know if I jump down this cliff, you're gonna be at the bottom to catch me. And as a fixed sign, okay, you, Taurus, Leo, and Aquarius, as a fixed sign, we're very, very self-reliant. We pride ourselves on our independence and being able to take care of ourselves, being self-sufficient, not needing another person. And especially, it makes us feel really uncomfortable to put our lives in somebody else's hands, right? Because we know ourselves really well. We know that our energy is fixed. When we say we're going to do something, we always follow through. And we don't trust a lot of people for that in that regards because things change, people change, and so I feel throughout your life many people have gravitated towards you, like friends, family members, lovers, because of your stability, because you are that anchor. When you say you're going to do something, they know you're going to follow through, and then they always like the people might not have been completely 100% either physically stable, emotionally stable, or even financially stable. But you're like that rock. You're like that really stable fixture that is constantly in the landscape. And I feel for many of you, they impose themselves upon you. So it's like your experience is colored by a series of relationship patterns and cycles, where the people that approach you, they crave your stability because they did not have the stability in themselves. And so you are constantly, again, like without knowing, drawing them in. Or maybe they just, drew stuck like they were sending out distress signals and I feel like it stuck, and so they were drawing you to them. And so whatever the situation is, it was like, in the past, I do feel a series of codependent relationships where you guys were always the pillar of strength and stability for a partner, a parent, a sibling, friends even. And if the when the situation was reversed, when you're not able to do it, they were not able to be there for you. And so I feel like, it was codependent in the past, and it was like one person shoulder the responsibility of the relationship, okay? And I feel, in any relationship, right, it's really nice to feel wanted and needed, right? To be able to take care of another person. But at the end of the day, if it goes on for years and decades, and if it's like unchecked, and if it's never reciprocated, who's gonna take care of you? You're giving all of yourself, all of your energy, all of your resources, every piece of yourself to, that relationship partner, that situation. And then on days when you could no longer give, or on days when you're not feeling well and you have to step down, no one has really stepped up. And you're starting to realize that, through the friendships, through the family relationships, through the love relationships even. I feel like nobody was able to match the level of devotion that a Scorpio is capable of giving, okay? That's just a fact. The Scorpio people are very, very deep, and you guys, I feel like emotionally, the depth of your emotion is runs very, very, very deep, and at times it can really scare you. And especially for those of you Scorpio moon people, you feel things very deeply. And I feel almost like when you're in a relationship, you want to like just wrap yourself up with the other person, melt together, become one, and it can feel a little bit scary for the other person, okay? And then for the Scorpio sun, I feel like you wanted to feel wanted and needed and desired, and you know, and so you do put up with a lot in relationships, but I do sense it was very tiring. It was taxing on you emotionally, okay? Because like, rather than going through your life, like, what am I gonna do? Where do I want my career to head towards? Where do I wanna live? Where do I wanna buy property? Where do I wanna get a house? Or where do I want to, you know, settle down and retire? Where can I invest my money? Like, all of the energy that you should have expended taking care of your soul, planning for your future, planning out your life, making these important decisions and really mulling it over, doing research, all of your waking hours are then focused on that codependent relationship. Does that make sense? So I feel like not only does it take from you energetically in the here and now, but it takes from you as well in the future, because all of your focus and your attention and the scope of everything you're dealing with is wrapped around the other person. Are they okay? Are they okay without me? Are they going to be okay tomorrow when I'm, you know, at work? Are they going to be able to take care of themselves? So I feel like energetically you have, you might not have realized how it affected you long term and how it affected you physically. Does that make sense? So all of your energy is was like siphoned off, okay? And every waking moment, I feel like you were concerned about somebody else. And then, you know, when let's say you're in your 30s, you're in your 40s, and when all of your friends, when all of your coworkers are thinking about, you know, saving up for a property, saving up for a wedding, saving up for a new car, progressing in their career, and even like investing so that they can, you know, have a really cushy retirement, your energy was not focused on these real life important decisions. And so I just want you to understand that it's really taking from you further into the future a lot more than you realize. And I hope that message, you know, kind of sinks in, because I feel that you need to draw back, and I feel that you need to plan things out long term. Okay? And so I feel like there was, you know, a series of toxic codependent relationships in your past. Moving into this phase right now, the shoe's on the other foot. So for once, you're meeting somebody who's very willing to reciprocate. You're meeting somebody who, when you step down, they're able to step up. And it feels to me like, you know, like the ground is shaking from under you for a little bit. And so when we're so used to being that anchor, and all of a sudden somebody else is, you know, carrying that mantle, we're just like, well, what do I do now? You know, I've always been the caretaker. I've always been the decision maker. I've always been the one that the other person relies on. And now the other person is taking over that role. Who am I? So a little bit of an identity crisis here for a few of you who have always taken care of other people. And now you're in a position where you can kind of coast. You can take it easy because your partner is really stepping up. And it feels a little bit unsettling. It feels a little bit scary. And in some ways, you're just like, wait a minute, can I really trust this? Can I really trust that, you know, this is not just a temporary thing that they're pulling? Like 3 months from now, when, you know, the puppy love or the infatuation wears off, are they going to turn nasty and sour? Or, you know, how long, like, it's almost like it's too good to be true. How long is this gonna last for me? Can I depend on this into my old age? Is it gonna be like, is there a time limit? Is there an expiration date? Is it going to be 5 years, 10 years, and then I'm on my own? So I feel like because we're so self-sufficient, or because you guys are aiming to have aimed, have worked at being very self-sufficient, that it's hard for you to be anything but. It's hard for you to take it easy. It's hard for you to trust that if they're no longer in the picture, you know, do I need to relearn, rewire my brain to be self-sufficient, to take care of myself again? And so what I do feel here is a little bit of a identity crisis that you guys are having, because once again, you know, when you are in relationships, I do feel that you guys get very wrapped up in it. And when you have a specific, you know, skill set as well, when you're when you do something, you tend to be very, very good at it. And that's what fixed signs are really about. They practice their craft, they hone their craft, and they aim to be the best, right? And so if someone tells you, wow, you're really dependable, you worked hard at it. You know, it didn't just happen overnight. It's not like a character trait. It just like you worked hard at it because that was important to you. And so it becomes a part of your identity. And then now that you don't have to, you know, be on time, be punctual, be dependable, it's like a part of that identity is shifting, and you're finding yourself trying to catch it. And I feel like in this situation, the universe is pretty much telling you, you know, take it easy, okay? All that intensity is, I feel like, is misdirected. And I feel that the advice here is take it easy. You're in good hands, okay? So going back to that image that I saw, one person helping another, climbing up cliffs, climbing up mountains, as well as descending cliffs and descending mountains. So there is definitely either a journey, a voyage that you and another person are fixing to embark on. Okay, so first of all, the cards are just echoing the same theme. We have here the Lovers. And underneath it, it says choice and trust, okay? So there's definitely a love relationship that is blossoming, thriving, or at least I feel like love is coming for you, okay? And this is, I feel, a very strong spiritual connection between two people, okay? A spiritual connection doesn't mean that we have to get along. It just basically means like a lot of the times when we have ideals or things that we believe in, or like preferences even, we're very much in alignment. Like we can agree on a lot of things. We can even agree on the big things and the little things. And so living together, working together, traveling together, and you know, spending the rest of your life together, it's harmonious. Okay, so this is pretty much about finding your kind of like your soulmate, your twin flame, finding somebody who is a lot like you, and finding somebody who is willing to explore this new territory with you. Okay, this is a very playful card, so it's contrary to the Rider-Waite, traditional Rider-Waite deck with the man and the woman and the angel. This card to me indicates a situation where it's very playful. There's a lot of passion too, but then I feel like in the spirit of exploration, what's lying ahead of us? I feel like if anything, if you were to travel, if you were to go anywhere, if you were to explore new territories, if you were in a strange environment, this is somebody you want by your side. Okay? They know how to survive. They know how to get by. They know how to, I feel like, you know, they don't mind getting their hands dirty. Scorpios, I've mentioned before, out of all the signs, okay, you and Aries and Capricorns, you, Aries, Capricorn, I feel like, let me see, Sagittarius sometimes, it depends with Sagittarius, but I feel like you and especially Capricorn, you and Capricorn, I would say more than any of the other signs, you don't mind getting your hands dirty. If something needs to be done, you're not going to sit there and, you know, keep scores and like, you know, tit for tat, like, well, I did it last time, why don't you do it this time? If something needs to be done, you roll up your sleeves and you get things done, okay? A lot of people can be very petty. It's like, you know, I did it last time, I don't want to do that, that's dirty, why don't you do that instead, okay? And a lot of people can be very calculating, even with the people that they love, to the point where it's like keeping scores. But I feel like with the Capricorns and with Scorpios, you don't do that, okay? Whatever, that's hard, no one wants to do it, and it needs to be done, it needs to be done, right? So you roll up your sleeves, you get your hands dirty, and you get it done. And so I feel like you found a partner that is very similar to you, where they don't sit there and they don't try to pawn off the yucky stuff on you. You know, they get things done, okay? And so this is kind of like your ride or die. This is somebody who is who's going to take care of you to your old age. This is somebody who's like, you know, when you're no longer young and attractive and, you know, fit, like, they're not going to leave you. If you're no longer have a full bed of hair, if you're no longer, you know, youthful, they're not going to leave your side. So I feel like you have a really strong connection here where it's a ride or die type of a relationship. And I feel that there isn't anything that can, you know, shake the foundation of this relationship. I feel like it is very strong and it is very solid. Okay, so let me talk about your fears, okay? Because it's coming out very strongly. So you have some insecurities regarding this relationship. You trust the other person. So your insecurities, once again, is not about the other person. The insecurities are internal. So let me talk a little bit about that. So it might be uncomfortable, but I feel like it needs to be brought up, okay? Because I can feel it. So this is your energy here. We have here the Queen of Cups, okay? So I look at this as somebody who's been in one place for way too long, okay? The environment around her, it's like she's got barnacles growing on her, okay? They're like seashells, crustaceans, and like barnacles. And in this environment, it's like the tree, like the seaweeds, the plants, the moss, whatever, the algae, they're starting to bloom, okay? So it indicates to me that you've been in one place for too long, okay? What I feel is there's a lot coming in for you. And once again, you know, you're unable to budge, okay? This is a very heavy animal, right? It has to kind of like waddle down the side of the rocks or down the surface in order to get back into the water, okay? And so it's just sitting there waiting, but not really acting. And so while something's coming in for you, I just feel like you're looking at it very skeptically, okay? And underneath that, on the shadow end of it, this is like your shadow side. This is like these are the things that I want to talk about. You have a fear that by relying on another person, it's going to make you very vulnerable, either emotionally dependent on them, financially dependent on them, or even like you feel like this is the arrival of this person might also signify the departure of this person, okay? Which basically means that, you know, well, they're here today, but like, you know, when things get rough or when times get tough, are they gonna be around? And so you've lived your life being the caretaker, being self-sufficient, and now you don't know how to be anything else but. And as much as you trust the other person, you're not really sure if they have a limit. You know, am I going to be too much of a burden for them? Am I going to be too dependent on them? Am I being too needy? Am I being too, you know, insecure in this relationship? Are they going to get tired of me? Are they going to get bored? Are they going to be okay taking on this role and these responsibilities for, you know, for the rest of time? Is this relationship really going to stand the test of time? So, you know, what if, like, I need to get down that cliff and I'm not able to? Are they going to extend a helping hand? Or are they just going to get sick and tired of it and just, you know, turn their back on me when I need them? And so I feel like you have some fears here, and these are like very deep rooted fears about your own capabilities. And I feel like your own strength, your own capabilities, your own mortality. You know, that's what I'm feeling. And of course, for a Scorpio person, talking about the things that you're that scares you. You guys have been through a lot, okay? Your sign rules the eighth house, and the eighth house is like, I look at it as like a bucket of tar, okay? It's dark, it's pitch black, it's viscous, it smells. The eighth house is, it drags up all of the things that make us feel very, very afraid, okay? It is the house, in astrology, it's the house of rebirth, regeneration, okay? So it's like having to, you know, dive into the underworld and then come out clean, okay? Having to like bathe yourself in that bucket of tar and then come out sparkling clean. That's what it feels like. You guys have been through, you know, periods and bouts where you've had to like reinvent yourself, okay? Reinvent your identity. You have to have gone through, like many of you have gone through, really intense experiences, and you came out okay. And so because you've been through so much, I'm sorry, I lost my train of thoughts. I feel like because you've been through so much, you know yourself really well. You know your breaking point. You know where your limits are. And you know what you want, okay? It's like hardship builds character. But I feel like with this person, the way they show up here, eight of feathers, it's like a little mouse. It's very cute. It's very pure. It's very innocent, possibly very young. So there could potentially be an age difference. You're looking at this person as like someone who's a little bit skittish, okay? So mice, they're a little bit nervous, okay? This is also someone who's very resourceful, okay? But you're looking at this playful, cute little mouse, and you're just like, you haven't been through what I've been through. You haven't been tested. You don't really know yourself well. So I feel in a way you might be underestimating this person, okay? And so you're kind of wondering, you know, I've been through a lot. I know what I want. They haven't been through half what I've been through. They might not know what they want. And so I feel like you might also be doubting this person in terms of like, well, maybe they want more. Maybe they'll change their mind. Maybe they'll get bored. Maybe they'll get tired of me, or, you know, whatever the situation is. I just feel like you know where you stand, but you're not really sure you know where the other person stands. You see the best in them, but you also, I feel like a very strong protective paternal vibe in here, where there might be an age difference and somebody feels like paternalistic or maternalistic, and somebody feels very protective over the other person. And so what I'm sensing here is, keep in mind, remind yourself, okay, you guys are on equal footing here, okay? This is like, regardless of age, regardless of life experiences, these two animals are like the same age, the same soul group, the same. It's like you guys have, let's say if you're an old soul and you have, you know, reincarnated like 100 lifetimes, they're also an old soul. So spiritually, you guys are on the same footing, Okay, you guys are from the same like soul group. You guys are from the same group. And so even if physically they're in front of you and they look very young and it seems like they haven't really lived, they're also a very old soul. And so you can trust what's in front of you. You can trust in this connection. And you can trust that if you ask for help, they're gonna be there to lend a helping hand. Okay, they're gonna help you down that cliff, and they're going to fight alongside you, and they're going to protect you. And so I feel like this is the beginning, okay, the beginning of putting yourself in a place where you don't have to be the caretaker. You don't have to be the one constantly pushing the relationship forward. Somebody's doing that for you. Or at least, you know, two people I see who are definitely on equal footing. And then I'm also feeling whatever that's keeping you very hesitant about embarking on a new phase, a lot of it is unfounded fears, and a lot of it is coming through from your end. It's not really grounded in reality. Does that make sense? And so maybe you have to kind of like get over this, or somehow work this out of your system, because I feel like it might ruin a good thing. Okay, it might disallow you from trusting in the connection. It might make you turn down a very good offer. Or it might keep you mired in a state of like disbelief, negative thoughts, you know, like, well, they're here today, but are they going to be here 5 years from now, 10 years from now? So whatever it is, it's very internal to you, Scorpios, and it's something that you need to work through. Okay, it's not fair to project these fears onto your partner, or onto the person you're dealing with, or onto this situation. Does that make sense? So I would urge you to try your best to somehow purge this. And the best way to counter negative thoughts is to think positively. Okay, so that's the only advice that I can give. And so we're moving on. And I do see another person on this side, so let me talk about that. I feel like some of you are dealing with this and things are all gravy. You just need to kind of like work through some of your fears when it comes to vulnerability, when it comes to like joint finances, like sharing assets and money with another person. I feel like some of you might have been burned in the past lending out money and it was never returned. And I'm talking like huge sums of money to somebody that you really care about, because you cared about them. And I feel like, you know, you really, really worked hard to secure that money to help them, and then it was never returned. And so it left a bitter taste in your mouth. And now the thoughts of like having a shared bank account with another person, I just feel like it takes you to a dark place just thinking about it. And then I also feel there might have been, you know, in the past, you gave your all to a situation. You gave everything. Every piece of yourself, every fiber of your being. And I'm looking at this armadillo, and it doesn't have any hairs in it, any hairs on it. It doesn't have any fur. It's like naked and out in the elements. That's what it feels like, exposed, has nothing. And that situation didn't work out. And now you're very skeptical about investing and loving and opening up and giving so much of yourself. And so you're metering, you're keeping a quota, you're holding back. Once again, these are issues that are very personal to each of you who might be watching this. And so I would just say, you know, this is a new scenario here, this is a new situation, this is a new person. And so, you know, don't shut yourself out. Don't be your worst enemy, and don't get in your own way, because I feel like it's disallowing you from really enjoying the blessings that are coming into your life, okay? So let's move that aside. It keeps drawing me back. So I want to just separate it and talk about the things that are coming in from this end. I do see some of you are like dealing with this and you kind of need to work that out. And then another person, there's another person here that some of you are dealing with. You could be dealing with both, but I feel like the energy is separated. So, sorry, let me take a sip of water. Okay, so there's a person that is heavily thinking about you, okay? I don't know if they have moved recently. I don't know if they have moved on, like if they physically have moved to a new city, a new location, and there's like geographical distance, or if they have moved on, like they're dating somebody else now, they're in a new relationship. So there's somebody that has moved on, like you might have broken up with this person and they might have moved on. And I feel like you wish the best for them, like you think about them, you care about them a lot, okay? And I feel like for many of you, this might be like somebody you were once married to, you once lived with. This was somebody who was very, very significant in your life, okay? Quite significant. I feel like they moved on. I feel like they left your life, they've moved on. Their career is picking up with the Chariot. They're at the peak of their career. And this is somebody that is like, I'm looking at the Rhino, thick skin, okay? Possibly very hard-headed, okay? And so the thing that might have driven a wedge between the two of you is that, like, ideological differences, okay? I feel like you're looking at this person and you're thinking this person is like, they have it in their head, things are a certain way. Even though reality is showing them otherwise, they're still so fixed in their opinion, so fixed in their trajectory, so fixed in the things that they're doing, that they're like, it's hard to bend this person. And when things don't bend, they break, right? So I feel like it broke the relationship. And I also feel as well, for some of you, if you have done this person wrong, and I feel for many of you, this is like somebody from long ago. If you are the one, the Scorpio I'm talking to, if you have done this person wrong, I feel that you're thinking about them heavily, wanting to make amends. Okay, you're thinking about it. I don't see that you're, you know, reaching out, trying to text them or send them an email or trying to look for them on social media or trying to hunt them down. I feel that, you know, you think about this person and you think about what could have been, and you kind of like think about, you know, it's like they're very high on your pedestal, okay? And then you kind of use their qualities as like the barometer for which you assess like new relationship partners. Like they're that special, they're that amazing. And that's saying a lot. And I feel like that's for some of you who might have let this person get away. You're thinking about everything in your life and you might have a lot of financial abundance. You might have the nice house, you know, the career is going really well. You are taking like tropical vacations, you know, to like really exotic locales and in the sun, enjoying the warm water and sitting on the beach and, you know, sipping your pina coladas or whatever. And you wish that person were there with you to share the experiences with you. And I feel that you're heavily thinking about them. So the month of February might bring back, you know, that sense of nostalgia, that sense of like the one that got away, that sense of like, I wonder what they're up to. I wonder what they're doing. I wonder what, how they're doing. I wonder if they miss me. So once again, I feel like many of you are in this because this came out first. And then a few of you are thinking about this, and especially the few of you who might have wronged the other person, okay? And you know, at the end of every relationship, right, it takes two to tango. And so I feel like I'm not saying like anyone is really at fault, but I feel like the fault over here might lie with the Scorpio person, especially the Scorpio moon. Okay, so I'm sensing here there's nostalgia, there's like thinking back of to a previous partner or relationship, and there's like wondering what the other person's up to, wondering what they're doing. I can assure you they're moving on with their life, or they have moved on, and I feel like they're seeing somebody else, and I feel like they're happy, and I feel like their career is going really well, and so you don't have to wonder. Okay, I feel like they're fine. So there's that, and that's weird, but that's very specific for some of you who might be thinking that. And I feel like if you're thinking that, you're probably single, and you're looking at all the things around you, you know, the nice apartment or the nice house, the money in the bank, the tropical vacations, and you're longing to contact this person, or you're longing to reach out to this person and wanting to share the experience with that person. For some of you, it could be like an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, that you have dealt with in the past. For others, it could be specifically like a Cancer that you're dealing with. We have here the Chariot, Cancerian card, and we have here the Ten of Cups. This is like the apex of emotional satisfaction, right? Having everything at your disposal, and hence I said, you know, you're looking around at your life, you're very content, you have the ability, you have disposable income, you can go come and go as you please, you have a very stable job, you have a roof over your head. Not only that, you have a really nice place that you're living in, and you're kind of like everything is laid out here, but and you do want to have another person to share this experience with you. And then the King of Pentacles, once again, Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You could also be dealing with a Cancer, okay? So that's what I'm feeling. I feel like the other person has moved on, and I feel like this is a situation that you can reach out, and they will reciprocate. Like, they will reach back out to you. They will respond and update you on what's going on in their life. But I feel like that sense of longing, like wanting that person back, I feel like it's fleeting, okay? It's like you might develop a new friendship with them rather than a love relationship. So I feel like something has transformed here, and it can't really be gone back to in the same way. So whatever you have now, at its best, it's going to be friendship, okay? Which is great too. We all need friends, right? And so if you want to, if you must, you can reach out. But I do feel like they have moved on with their life. They're geographically, they're elsewhere, and I feel like life is going really well for them too. So towards the end of the month, I want to talk about a few other things, okay? I have here Six of Cups, and the Six of Cups is a very strong soul connection, okay? So you have two really powerful cards here that indicates a twin flame, a soulmate connection. So the Lover's card and the Six of Cups. So two of the best cards when it comes to love and romance and relationships. And it's like bookending this reading, okay? One came out at the very beginning, one came out at the very end. So I feel like everything in between is just wedged in between these two really positive cards. And so you need to overcome whatever is over here, okay, Scorpio? You need to be able to look at it for what it is. We have here the Queen of Swords, and the Queen of Swords is like, I look at this card as coming out of the Bat Cave, okay? The Bat Cave is very dark. It's mildewy, and you guys have a really strong sense of smell. It's dank and dark, and it might not smell very nice in there. And so this is kind of like, you know, flying out of it, okay? Flying out into, you know, a bigger and crisper environment. Not being in a place with humidity and just dank and stale air. Giving yourself like a lot more room, a lot more space, being able to really enjoy your environment. So I feel like whatever insecurities or vulnerabilities you're feeling here, that's making you, is making things uncomfortable for you to take the next step. Okay, it feels burdensome. It feels like I don't want to be a burden to another person. I don't want them to tire of me. I don't want them to, you know, feel like I'm draining them. I don't want them to look at me as if I'm weak and codependent, and you know, and they might not respect me. So there's a lot of things here. And keep in mind that I mentioned, you know, you have to overcome these things. The other person cannot do that for you. These are our own inner demons that we have to fight, right? And the way that we fight them is to, you know, meet negative self-talk with positive self-talk, like swap the energy. Does that make sense? Just swap the energy. When you feel these negative self-talk or negative thoughts creeping in, you need to counter it with a positive thought, a positive affirmation, okay? And I feel almost like you want reassurance. You want verbal reassurance from the other person, but you don't know how to ask. Once again, you don't want to put yourself in a situation where you're vulnerable. You don't want the other person to lose respect for you. You don't want the other person to hear all of your inner demons, because it is scary in the mind of Scorpios. And so I feel like with this Queen of Swords energy, wave it away, okay? Slice these demons away and get out of that bat cave. The bat cave can feel very comfortable if you are a Scorpio, but if you want more out of your life, and if you know you want success and forward movement and momentum as indicated in this Chariot card, you need to find firmer footing, and you need to get out of this state of negativity. And a lot of it is like a vicious cycle of negative self-talk, okay? And what you're being blocked with, once again, the shadow, this is the devil, okay? And gear yourself up for battling your inner demons and overcoming all these things that are really holding you back. And what's coming through as well is Six of Cups. You have a relationship partner that will be by your side. Okay, and so all of these things here are internal conflicts that you need to get through, okay? The way that I see this playing out is the love and the support coming through from this person is very unconditional. They're a really good person, and I feel like they really, really care about you. Not only do they care about you, they're a very good person. So they will never leave anyone high and dry. They would never leave anyone stranded. Okay, on top of that, and the fact that they care about you, they would never leave you in that condition, let alone, you know, anybody else. So I feel like you're in good hands, no matter how you look at it, okay? Even if the love is gone out of the relationship, even though if they're no longer in love with you or you're no longer in love with them, they're still a very good person. And so they will never leave you high and dry. And I feel like you just need to kind of like keep that in mind, okay? I hope the reading resonates with you, and then I hope it is helpful for you as we navigate the energies of February, because I feel like these demons are gonna, you know, start creeping in, and you're going to feel a little bit insecure, and you're going to need to, you know, fight them off, okay? Okay, so whatever you can do to do that, if you need that reassurance from the partner, maybe you just need to ask them. Okay, but either way, I feel like there's a connection here that is very playful. It's very loving and caring. There's a lot of attraction. There's also a lot of like, you know, reciprocity. I help you here, you help me there, and no one needs to ask for anything of one another. And so I feel like you have a very intuitive understanding of the other person, and vice versa, they towards you. And so I feel like this is a really strong connection, and I'm glad you have found this person. For others, if you're single, reach out to that ex, but just know that I feel like, you know, the situation has changed, okay? It's like, it's more friendship based now, which is still great, okay? I'm going to leave it at that. I will talk to you guys next month, and happy Valentine's Day for those who are celebrating. For those who are still emailing me regarding private readings, I don't do those anymore. I do have a link in the description box below for a colleague. Her name is Bridget, and she is psychic. She is based out of California, and I highly recommend that you get a reading from her. I've gotten readings from her over the years, and I find her to be very... she gets messages very fast, and also she's very accurate, and she is very helpful. Like, she has provided tremendous spiritual guidance for me, so I recommend it. Okay, so if you're looking for spiritual advice and that's what you need to get through this, then either way, I hope the reading finds you well. Okay, take care of yourself. All right, Scorpios, I will talk to you guys soon. Bye bye.